Jump has an Explore Outlier platform available under Analyze, then Screening, and is now even more powerful. If you're just interested in the new features, scrub to the end of this video, but let me first provide a quick refresher of the platform. One definition of an outlier is a data point in a graph or set of results that is very much bigger or smaller than the next nearest data point. Jump helps us quantify that difference and do something about it. The platform helps you identify outliers and perform specific actions where you can explicitly accept the outliers, reject, or even accommodate. With a subset of the probe sample dataset, I'll first analyze with a distribution of one of the columns I suspect has outliers. I can identify visually in this distribution I have some outliers on the low side and some on the high side. Leaving this distribution report open, I'll navigate to Analyze, Screening, Explore Outliers, where I'll be stepped through the Explore Outlier process with a series of helpful windows. I'll first add the numerical column I want to analyze and then select OK. In this window is where I'll select Quantile Range Outliers. You can read the other options on your own, and I've linked a wonderful video tutorial by Lidi, our Jump statistical trainer. In the Explore Outlier window, I now observe 44 outliers using the methods above. If I were to change these values, I would need to rescan in the outlier report at the top. I'll get to the actions I can take in a few seconds. If you have a nines report where this is showing I have a significant 38 values, many times the data has high nine values, I can perform some decisive actions by deleting the values, replacing the cell with missing data, which is not ideal, or accepting the values, protecting your data as a missing code column property. This enables you to analyze your data, not considering those column cells, but the data is still there. It's a best practice not to delete data. Selecting the first action missing code values, I'll receive a jump alert stating my data value has changed and I'll need to save later. It will appear as nothing has happened to our data, but it has. Returning back to the table, we can see an asterisk in the column indicating a column with missing values and the column property associated with the high nine values. Now I'll go back and rescan, and my high nine report will disappear. And you can see now that I've reduced the outliers from 44 to 6. That's pretty cool. Now we're dealing with outliers in our analysis, not high nine values. And now I can take identifier actions like select rows, color cells, exclude rows, or color rows. And we have a few options to clear the outliers in the tables. We can expand the commands, the window we saw earlier, and investigate other techniques or methods and return a different outlier value or values. You can investigate these outlier methods in the Jump Statistical Library. Many times the type of distribution will determine your ideal method of outlier identification. Lidi references a book to consider, Barnett and Lewis, Outlier in Statistical Data. And finally, some updates to the platform include a new robust PCA, which replaces the multivariate robust outliers. Multivariate robust outliers continue to be supported by JSL only and cannot be accessed through menus. Robust PCA identifies cells, continues to respect the multivariate structure of the data, allowing missing values, which is much faster than the Huber feature used in previous Jump versions. Robust PCA supports creating a clean set of new columns with imputed values for missing and variously truncated values for the outliers. K-nearest neighbors has been enriched to provide more details on the largest outliers.